Hello, beloved. How are you? How are you today? It is a beautiful day in the city of New York. I'm blessed. I'm grateful. I am in a good mood. You are listening to Red Sable, and this is Feed Your Mind, Fuel Your Soul's special edition of Visionary Views. We have another amazing, captivating interview for you today. This one will feature The Refresher. He's a motivational speaker. He's a brand creator and owner. He is a content creator and a podcaster and so much more. Enjoy the show today. There will be music afterwards, of course, because you know how I do. But listen to the words that he has to say today, okay? And I appreciate every single one of you for continuing to stop by, lending me your ears, your time, your attention, your energy, and for yet another day, your attention. I appreciate that. And whatever you have to do today, I pray and hope that it is going to be a greater day for you than it was yesterday. I hope that you continue to peel back all the old skin as we shed old skin every day. We become more of who we were created to be every day. And it may not feel like that, but transformation is happening even in our sleep. We start changing the way we think and what we do, who we hang around. We change our diets, the way we dress, our hair, and everything else that we do that put us in dark places and spaces and dumped us in pits and left us while they poured lava on us and wanted us to die, right? They wanted the death of the spirit to come to you. They wanted the death of your dreams to come to you. They wanted the death of your encouragement to come to you. They wanted you to lie in the waste of pain, defeat, struggle, and giving up. But you're not going to give up, right? You're going to continue to run the race that you was created to run, because you know that if you run this race, which is a marathon of life, it is not a sprint. You face forward and you keep your eyes in front of you towards the goal, not to the left or the right. And you definitely don't need to look behind you, because you will slam into a blocker or wall that will stop you, detour you into a different direction. We need to focus on what's ahead. God said to put blinders on as we move forward for the races that he has created every single one of us to run. And if we do not give up, we will reap a great reward. We don't know what our rewards will be individually, but we do know that God keeps all of his promises. So keep dreaming, stay close to him, and move about your life with humility and honor and patience and love. You need a lot of love to overcome some of the struggles, especially when they keep on trying to drown us in the pit and burn us alive, our dreams and our hopes and all that comes with making us who we were meant to be. We are anointed, we are gifted, we are talented and creative, and they continue to block us because they follow the path of the blockers, who become wicked in their ways, who become, not necessarily that they are doing things to hurt people physically, but they are doing things to emotionally and mentally kill your joy, because that is what the enemy wants his minions to do. So be mindful, and I will continue to speak of that because it is rampant today and it is everywhere today, from what we buy in the stores to the advertisements we see through our social media feeds and on television. It is standing next to us at the bus stop or on the train. It is the person that's driving the taxi cab who has a sudden attitude with you for no real reason. But all of a sudden, he chooses a variant of ways to do something to make you feel bad for no reason. Why? Because he's in a bad place, right? So, beloved, as you go through your day today, hold on to who you are becoming and don't let anybody rock your core. Remember, we talked about this the other day. Sway in the root of the foundation that you are standing on. And if you are a believer, then you know that strong foundation is God, and you cannot rock God's foundation. You cannot rock God's core. And if his core is within you, then it's not going to rock you either. You're just going to sway. You're going to bend, but you won't break. And yes, there are broken parts of you, but the root is still there. So do not forget about your root. You stand strong in your root and stand covered in the armor of God, because you know that you are not alone. He has not left you or forsaken you. Okay? Know that you are loved, created by love, for love, with love, to love, out of love, because of love, because God is love. So know this about yourself. Walk in your anointing. Walk in your calling. Posture up in your purpose. Okay? We need to learn how to walk with our heads up and our shoulders back, because we are royalty. We are God's chosen children. So I hope that you embrace these words today and add some affirmations of your own and remember who you are and whose you are, beloved. Okay? So we're going to go on into the amazing interview with Mr. Sean Jackson, a.k.a. The Refresher. Okay? This interview is going to inspire you. It is, because it inspired me. I appreciate you. Let's get started.
To do is center this all around you. I don't know how much time you have, but it is all good. So I appreciate it. And I'm waiting for a few more people to come in. I've been promoting and everything. So how was your day today? Was it good?
Just another day to do better, be better. I tell everybody that you want to wake up each day as if it was a purpose. And is that like just attack each day like that, and that's how I get my day. Just to do better, be better every single day, and that's the way of life.
That is very good. That is very true too. The mindset thing, right? Mind over matter.
Definitely, always.
Mm-hmm. Well, that is good. Okay, so. And let me just make sure the levels are.
How was your day, Queen?
Oh, my day was crazy busy, but it's all good. It's busy, a lot going on. Had a lot to do preparing for today, because I had an interview right before you that just finished like 10 minutes ago. And then I had some other things I had to take care of. So, yeah. But if you're not busy doing something, then you're not moving. And if you're not moving, that's not good, right?
Exactly. You're not being you're not being productive.
Productive.
You gotta be able to do something, because if you ain't doing nothing, then you're not really evolving or going nowhere in life. So tell people that all the time, the more you move and do something and just have that accountability and take that initiative, you go far in life, literally. Like,
Okay, so are you able to turn up like the volume on your phone or the mic that you're using?
You're definitely, can you hear me now, Queen?
Yeah, that's a little better. Is it really hot where you are?
It is scorching hot, like literally hot. It's crazy.
I know, and I wish it would stop, because this heat, it's hard to get anything done, because it makes you tired. It makes you tired, makes your head hurt. It's crazy.
I'm from Florida, so I'm used to it, though, Queen. Like, I'd rather deal with the heat than deal with the snow, you know?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's right. I forgot you're in Florida. What part of Florida are you in?
No, I'm in Maine right now at the moment.
Oh, you're in Maine. Okay. Wow, in Maine.
It gets cold here.
It does? It gets cold. I've never been to Maine. I don't even think I, aside from you, that I even knew anybody who lived in Maine. That is crazy, but that's crazy cool, though. I like that. That's cool. It's good. It's good. It's a good thing.
I'm sorry. My bad. Go ahead.
It's all right. No. Go ahead. Say what you're going to say.
And I was going to say, it builds you up, because when you're able to go to a whole different state, you know, and I tell people all the time that you want to be uncomfortable, because if you're comfortable, you're never going to grow in life. So I was blessed to get left here. Like I told you, I got left in Maine, so I was blessed to get left here, because I was very uncomfortable for like a few years. And I really had to adapt and just tell myself to, to embrace it. You know, yeah, you're uncomfortable. You know, it sucks that you're not home in Florida. It's a different state, you know, a different environment. You know, just embrace it. And once you embrace it, you know, you'll see success. And I just embraced it. You know, I really embraced it and took off from there.
Okay. That's very good. I don't know. Like, what is it like in Maine? Is it like suburban? Is it city-like? Or what is it like there? I've never been.
Different areas. Like, you got the country, you know, it's more country than anything. You got a few city areas out here, but it's it's mainly like a tree state, animal state, you know. Got more moose. You see more wild deer in the streets than you'll see like a wild dog, so.
Yeah, wild deer just running around in the street?
Queen, you'll see.
Wow.
Tell you every morning, like you'll see about four or five deer in the road, just in the road. And as you're driving, they'll just like stare at you. They'll just stare at you because of the headlights, you know. So,
really,
so what do you do? Like, it's crazy.
Oh my goodness, have you ever been confronted by a wild deer? Like, what do you do? Do you get out the way? Do you move, or do you just stand still?
A wild deer, they don't bother you. They'll run more than anything. Now, I've been fortunate. I haven't been encountered with a moose yet, because they got moose out here as well, too, that be in the streets. Mm-hmm. And they actually had moose deaths over the years. Like, people would just run into a moose, and the moose would crush them in their car. Well, crush them inside their car. So, it's crazy.
Wow. All right, love, give me 1 second. Let me take this message and see if this is someone calling for you. Oh, Tanika Drake.
Hey, Red Sable and Refresher, how are you doing? I just wanted to come in and stop by. This is T. Drake, the podcasting godmother connection. And I saw you guys talking, like, oh my gosh, I got to get in here. Because Refresher, I got to get with you soon. But I know you're so busy with the motivational healing summit coming up and so much. But I'm so glad you guys are talking. Whoop, whoop.
Yeah, we definitely gonna connect, T. You know, we gonna connect. I just got a wedding that I go to tomorrow, and then the following weekend I gotta fly to New Jersey. I gotta meet with John Blasgain. You know, guy who did.
Yes, I know him. I've worked with him.
Yeah. Yep. Yep. So I'm doing work with him. I gotta fly to New Jersey next weekend. So.
Okay. Good for you. That's fantastic. Okay, so we have some people in the building. We're going to begin. Thank you so much for joining us. My name is Red Sable. This is Visionary Views. And this is my esteemed guest, Mr. John Jackson, a.k.a. The Refresher. And he is going to share some of his time with us today and let us know about who he is, the man behind the vision, the man behind the brand, the man behind the microphones, and bring us into his world, okay? So let's begin. Now, do you prefer that I call you the Refresher or Sean, or what do you prefer?
I like the Refresher. I'm trying to make that stick.
Okay. Okay, so good. All right, so Mr. The Refresher. Okay, so you have told me a little bit about how you became this entrepreneurial mogul that you are forming yourself into being, but the audience doesn't know that. So let's start a little bit from the beginning and let us know, how did everything start for you? How did you become the brand? How did you become the Refresher? Why do you call yourself the Refresher?
From when I was homeless, you know, I didn't have much when I was homeless. So, and when I was homeless, I never considered myself a homeless person. You know, I tell people all the time, don't allow your current situation to define who you are as a person. You know, and I never really defined myself as a homeless person. So while I was homeless, you know, I gave away Jordans. I gave away, like, my Ralph Lauren clothes. I gave away, like, all my name brand nice clothes while I was in the shelter, you know. And I tell people all the time, when you bless others, there's always a bigger blessing among you. So I got the name Refresher because I gave this guy who was homeless, he lost his family, he lost his house, he lost his job, he lost everything. And I gave him a hat. I gave him a Jordan hat, and he loved that hat. He was like, yo, thank you so much. Like, this is a stepping stone in the right direction. You really just made my day. And he called me Smooth. He was like, I'm going to call you Smooth. And I loved that because I was able to empower him and turn his whole day around, because despite the fact that he lost everything, including his wife, and he was in a homeless shelter with me, he didn't allow that current situation to break him down as a person. He actually embraced the moment and was happy. So I came up with the Refresher just because I love to refresh people every now and then, that we all, you know, it's a battle. You know, it's a battle in life in general. You know, you got to put your hat on, think, and get through it. You know, you got to go through the three S's in life, which is suffer, sacrifice, and success. You know, and I was suffering, so I really had to sit down and think, what can I do to get myself out of the situation? You know, I was suffering, so I really had to make sacrifices in my life to achieve what I got now. So that's how I got a Refresher, by pointing to people at the shelter, being homeless myself. You know, a lot of people don't do that when they're homeless. Like, they're thinking about, oh, I'm homeless, I got to get out of here, how can I get out of here? You know, stuff like that. I wasn't thinking that. I was thinking about just helping other people out.
That's beautiful, though, thinking about others when you are in a situation that you don't want to be in. Thinking of others sometimes is the way to heal yourself and bring your own peace in a way that you won't be able to get it from any kind of thing that they could possibly give you anyway. So I definitely relate to giving to others when you are in a dark situation. So that's cool. So that's why he called you Smooth. So you call yourself the Refresher because you want to be able to refresh somebody's situation?
Exactly. You know, I felt empowered by just, I felt like I refreshed them, you know, because he was going through a dark time in his life. Even though I was facing a dark time in my life too, I was homeless. I didn't have nobody.
Yeah.
You know, I have no family in Maine, just me. And I really wanted to show him that there's a light towards the end of the tunnel. You just don't ever give up. Have hope, you know, and I wanted to give him hope. So that's why I call myself a refresher. I like to give people hope and let them know that, you know, there is a way. You know, if there's a will, there's a way.
So how did you, now you said that you were homeless and in a homeless shelter. Do you want to share how that happened?
Yeah, I was falsely accused. I was in a relationship, and the girl I was seeing at the time, she kind of cheated, you know, put me out. And well, she tried to put me out during the winter time when it was snowing up here. I think it was like 6 feet of snow on the ground at the time. And I was like, yo, like, I'm from Florida. Just give me like a week to go back home. Like, I get paid on Friday. I would literally buy a ticket and go back home. Like, just give me to Friday, I'd be out. And she's like, no, I want you out now. I said, yo, it's snowing outside. I had no family where I would go at. And so she went in the bathroom, lied, and, you know, called the cops. And told the cops that I beat her kid. And I don't beat my own children. I don't condone beating children, period. I do believe in being a strict parent, but I don't believe in beating children, you know what I mean? Because we have our own strength that we can't control sometimes, you know what I'm saying? So I really don't condone beating children. I got beat as a kid. I hated that. I hated getting whooped as a kid. So I ain't going to beat my kid, you know, but she lied and you know, told the cops that I hit a kid, and the cops believed her. And the crazy thing is, though, Sable, to that story, is that I was going to be a correctional officer during that time frame when all that happened. So the same jail that I got locked up at, I was already in the system. I passed every test flying colors to be a correctional officer. I was just set up to go to the academy. So when I got locked up at the same jail that I was, you know, going to be a corrections officer. So when I walked in intake, they're like, man, what happened? And I told them what happened, and I got out the next day. Why? Because they had all my stuff already in the system. I wasn't a bad person. I wasn't a menace to society. You know, I never been in jail, never been locked up until I came to Maine, literally. Never been in jail, never been locked up until I came to Maine. So, and, you know, that's what really sparked my fire, because I tell people all the time, when you go through pain, you know, pain is temporary. Like, it can last for a minute, an hour, a day, or a year, but eventually it will subside, you know, and something else will take its place. And I just kept telling myself that, yo, like, even though you're in pain, you're going through it, you know, there's better days, you know, just get through this time frame right now, just get through the storm, and, you know, there's better days ahead, you know?
Absolutely. So it's interesting because you said that you were originally from Florida, and this whole incident went down in Maine, a place you've never been, don't have any family, but you chose to stay there. So what made you decide to stay?
I wanted to grow as a person. And not only that, just I lost my mom in Florida. So losing my mother in Florida, I wanted to grow past that. And you know, family is one of the biggest, you know, people who are going to critique you and really bring you down if you're trying to elevate more than them, you know. And I wanted to be my own man. I wanted to find myself. And I tell people all the time, if you really want to find yourself and find your gift, you got to get away from your family. Like, it's good. I love my, don't get me wrong, like, I love my family to death. Like, I love my, I call my grandmother every single night. But sometimes if you got to grow as a person, as a woman or as a man, you got to find yourself. You got to find your path. You got to get away from your family and get away from your surroundings that you used to being around.
So you stayed in a place that initially you thought you was going to find some kind of comfortable pathway, but it became uncomfortable, and you turned that around by making your new uncomfortable comfortable, because you could have left. You could have chosen to go back to where you knew everybody and where you had family, and you knew they were going to take care of you because of the loss of your mom and everything. God bless her soul. I'm sorry for your loss. But you decided to make a whole new pathway, a whole new life for you, despite the horrible thing that happened. And so I applaud that, because most people would have just ran back home to where they knew.
I couldn't go back home, Queen. I had no money. I came to Maine on vacation with a bag of clothes, a pair of shoes on my feet, and literally $50 with the food stamps from Florida. And that's all I had. And once I ran out of food stamps, I had no money. I had no way to get back home. And, you know, I just went off the graces of God that people would just love my character. Like, hey, come over and hang out sometime, man. Come over and hang out. And then, you know, oh, man, what happened to you, man? Oh, you can stay here for a couple of days. Like, I was just going off hope, man. That really sucked when you have no family. And you got to, like, just pray that somebody would just be nice enough to say, hey, come over, man. Like, you're a good person, man. Come over and come hang out with me for a couple of days, man. Like, you don't got to go through that. Like, I didn't have that. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. It was really nice when I was to walk around 3 o'clock in the morning with my bag and trying to find somewhere to go. It's been a tough path to get where I'm at now, you know?
Yeah, I can imagine, and I could definitely relate. I've been homeless before, so I know that struggle. So you was finally able to get on your feet. What was the first turning point for you?
My first turning point when I got my three jobs.
Yeah, when you, yeah.
When I got my three jobs, I was working in security, I was working at Salvation Army, and then I was a FedEx package handler, which I was just scanning packages and loading trucks. And I got my breakthrough. One of my breakthroughs came through when I was scanning packages at FedEx. And I'm a crazy worker, man. Like, Queen, when I tell you, Queen, I'm a crazy worker. Like, I was in the warehouse running full speed up and down the belt scanning packages. Like, I was coming early in the morning at, like, 1 in the morning full of energy. Like, wake y'all behind up trying to get this money. Like, oh, y'all sleep, man. Y'all don't want no money, man. Go back home, man. Y'all don't want no money. And, like, management loved it. Like, wow, this guy, I was spoken, man. Like, Sean, do you want to lead stretches? Heck, yeah, I'll lead stretches. So I was going out there and lead stretches. And then my breakthrough came when the contractor just heard about me. And he came up to me, like, Sean, man, like, I see you performing well every single day. Like, you don't have no days off, man. You come in and you just bring that fire, man. I love that. Do you want to be a driver? I was like, heck yeah. So I was able to eliminate two jobs because my income as a driver I make more than I would at Salvation and, you know, doing a package handler. So I gave up those two jobs and I started driving for FedEx. And that's when I really got my breakthrough, because a lot of people, when you're a delivery driver, people invest money to the wrong things. Video games and stuff like that. Like, I invest my money into my business, and you know, I just started buying product. I got my LLC, and you know, that's when it really started happening, when I got my driving job.
That's fantastic, because of all the seeds that you've sown before you even got to the point where you knew what you was even going to do, not having anything but $50 in your pocket and no way to get back home, you decided to stay and turn it around and make the best out of what was given to you. And the reason why other doors started opening was because you had already been sowing seeds. You've been getting outside of yourself, getting out of your way, of your own pain, and giving to somebody else. And when God sees stuff like that, he rewards us in ways that we don't even think about. We just receive it, and we don't think that it's coming from him, but it is. So I'm happy to hear that you was able to stick it out. So you started UpStylish, right? UpStylish is, what is UpStylish? What is that? Is that a brand? Is that a fashion house? What is it? Or is it merch or what is it?
UpStylish is my brand that I'm creating right now. My goal, I have a corporation that I'm trying to build, but UpStylish is my brand that I'm putting under my corporation that I have a name for that too, but like, it's a brand that I'm trying to bring to the world that's going to be with my speaking, because I want to bring inspiration to the world. I want to inspire the world. I want my message. I want my voice to be heard around the world. So I created UpStylish to get my message heard, get people to inspire others. You know what I mean? Because, again, if you're in Walmart and you're having a bad day at work or in general and you see a quote, literally a quote on the back of a shirt, that quote alone could turn your whole day around. It can really resonate with you. Like, hey, I love that quote.
And that quote can really empower you as a person. And that's the message I'm trying to bring to the world with upstylists. You know, don't get down, just up your style, you know, up your standards. That's the way of life.
Okay.
Standards, you know.
Okay. I like it. So is it for men and women, children? Who's this line specifically for?
That's gonna be for men, women, kids. I'm doing dog clothes, I'm doing shades. I'm doing it all.
I love it. Okay. So I also know that you are into fitness. And how did that come about? Where did you start your actual fitness journey?
About 2 years ago. I'm 2 years deep now. I'm like on 124 day week streak. And I started my fitness journey 2 years ago. And it's funny because when I first started, I couldn't lift 80 pounds. I couldn't bench press 80 pounds. Now I'm bitching 315 pounds. But I started my fitness journey because that's the way to defeat your mind. Because if you're in the gym, and I don't care if it's 10 pounds, if you're doing a lot of reps, you're going to feel it. So if you get to like the last rep in your body and your mind telling you to stop, and you push past that rep and you do it, you just defeated your mind, you know, and you can use that on literally throughout your whole life. Like, if you're having a bad day, you can just push yourself through that bad day. I do it every single day on my truck. You know, I had one time I walked in and I had 225 deliveries to do, like packages, houses to deliver in a day. And I was like, I spazzed out at work because that's a lot of stuff. Like, I was getting that. Till like midnight, but I got what I can on my truck. You know, I thought to myself and I pulled myself out of that mind frame. You know, and that's what it's all about. It's the mindset. It's the mind, and that's the gist of my business. The gist of myself to get people past that mindset. Because out of 365 days out of the year, you're gonna have a bad day. It's gonna happen, but you gotta be able to talk yourself out of it. You know.
So. The fitness is a way for you to continue to be able to find, because I do different kinds of things in order to help me to recenter myself, to find my peace, to be able to get rid of whatever stress or anxiety that I may be feeling. So I'll do music, I'll dance, I'll get some workout going on. Is fitness, but I'm not lifting 350 pounds. That's not, no.
You don't gotta do that, Queen. I say yes because I had a dude come in the gym and I was lifting, and he was like, "Bro, I don't think I can do that." I said, "Man, that's your mind. Maybe you just see the weight. I mean, he's a guy, so obviously I'm gonna challenge him heavy because he's a guy. But a female, I'm put her on lightweight because I don't want you to bulk up. I want you to slim down. So I'm put you on lightweight." But he seen the weight, and he was like, "Man, I don't think I can do that." I said, "Bro, that's your mind talking to you. Just try it." And he tried it and he did it. I said, you see what you just did? You just beat your mind. Your mind told you to stop because you seen the weight and you never did it. And you was like, I can't do it. And then you just did it and you did it. You just beat your mind.
Wow. Okay. All right. Let's take a little bit of a break and see who is calling. Okay. This is from Positive. Let's see what he has to say.
Hey, my friends, Red Sable and the Refresher. I jumped on when you guys jumped on. I had some time, wanted to listen to both of you. Just want to say, I love this. To the Refresher, thanks for sharing. I think that's what it's all about, sharing our stories to the world. I won't make this too long because I got to step out right now, but keep doing your thing, everyone. Keep your head up, keep moving forward. Once again, thanks for sharing your story, Refresher, and all the best moving forward.
Oh, thank you, PV. We appreciate you. That was Positive Vibes.
Thank you. I thank you, man. I appreciate you, King, a lot, man. Thank you, brother. Always, man. Thank you a lot.
Okay, so now you are motivating people in the gym. You're motivating people wherever you meet them inside of your work. You are also a motivational speaker. How did you get into that? What inspired you to get into motivating speaking, motivate speaking?
I've been that way my whole entire life. You know, every time I get around my peers and we sit down and we talk, they're like, Sean, man, you're always intellectual. You're always talking that deep stuff, man. That's always a deep conversation with you. Like, you always real. And, like, that's just who I am. Like, I love being that way. Like, I love being real, being that accountability partner that's going to hold you accountable, because I'd rather you hate me and get better than like me and stay the same. You know, so I always been that friend that always been around, like, you know, that you can't do that, man. You slacking, don't be doing that, you know, so. Literally, so like that's why, Queen.
Okay. So my question is this, and I know that a lot of people find it just a lot to always be motivated and inspired and always be positive all the time. Do you find it challenging on some days that you just have to talk yourself into your own situation of being grounded in your positive space? Or does it just come naturally? Are you just getting up in the morning and there it is?
I used to be that way, but now it comes naturally, because even when my day is off, I get up at 3 a.m, I just wake up. It just, my kids drive me every single day. You know, I tell people all the time, kids will drive you because they're sponges. Like, my son called me the other day on video, he lives in Florida, and he's like, Dad, I play football just like you, I got my pads. I said, I'm proud of you. I was like, so what you want to be when you grow up? He's like, I want to play the NFL, Dad. You can. Dad going to be right there with you on draft day when they call you number one, you know, to go number one in the NFL. But guess what, son? You got to start now. You got to work for it now. You know, you see your father getting up 3 a.m, going to the gym, lifting weights. I'm not following my peers. I'm not going to the club. I'm not drinking. I'm not doing anything that's going to waste my time. I'm literally using my time wisely. I'm being a producer, not a consumer, you know?
Okay. I love that. I love the positive connection between you and your son, and the fact that you are able to hone into his future of becoming more of a positive thinker, that you're not just patting him on the back and saying, okay, good job. You're giving him tools that he's going to need to use in order for him to get through those bad days as well. So that's fantastic. Now, of course, welcome. Who were your inspirations when you were growing up? Who inspired you? Was it your parents? Was it a teacher, a mentor?
I would say my mother. You know, my mother inspired me a lot. My mom, God rest her soul, she had sickle cell. And, you know, she was diagnosed with sickle cell as a child. And she grew up with that. So, imagine as a kid growing up watching mom struggle with sickle cell. You know, she couldn't even work anymore. It got to the point she couldn't work. So, and, you know, despite, she had so many surgeries, like Sable, she had open heart surgery, she had hip surgery. She had so many ports cut into her. And she never made one excuse. You know, she had to get up to go to the doctor. She did that. She had to cook for us. She did that. She had to clean the house up. Like, she never made one excuse about what she was going through, what pain she was going through. Like, she just got up and just did it. And, like, that's why I am the way I am now. Like, I have a hurt shoulder. I'm not 100% right now, but I still go hard because, like, my mother never made one excuse, you know, despite, like, I can remember days when she was going through a sickle cell crisis, and, like, crisis is something that you never want to see, because you literally imagine as a kid and your parent just in a fetal position, and you walking in, and like you, if you touch her, she just screams, you know, like you can't touch them, period. Like, a fingertip will hurt them. Like, that's how bad a crisis is. So, like, you imagine as a kid, like, just watching your mom go through that. And I said, she never made one excuse. She got up and she handled her business, and she had to handle to get done as an adult. And that inspired me, you know, just watching her as a kid. And that's why I tell people it's very important to do that now as parents. Like, even though we're going through pain and tragedy, even though we're having heartaches, even though we're having bad days, it's very important to always have a positive mind, always keep the down. Like, you know, when you get to yourself, reflect. that's when you can reflect and have that time to really think and, you know, get down on yourself. But when your kids are watching, you always got to keep that upbeat attitude. You got to keep that positive flow going because they're watching you. You want your kids to be great, you know?
So would you say, and that's fantastic that you was able to, because when we're young, we see our parents go through certain things and we just don't want them to be hurt. We don't want them to be in pain. And we want to do our best to try to help them in any way that we can. But there's so much that you can do when you're just a kid, right? So when those days came around and you weren't able to do anything, how did you cope with that? Because my mother, she didn't have any kind of illness, but she did have addiction. And it was hard for me because as the eldest child, I had to step in and do all kinds of things for my siblings that she couldn't do. So it put me in a position of leadership when I didn't even know that that's what I was doing. I was feeling resentful because I felt like I wasn't supposed to be the parent. But at the same time, I know that I didn't want my mother to suffer either. So how did you make that transition into realizing that you needed to be more than just her son? Because at some point you became her caretaker at some point, correct?
I didn't know what to do. I was scared. Like, yeah. I was hurt. Like, that was my, I didn't want to see my mom go through that pain. My grandmother, thank God for my grandmother. Like I said, I call my grandmother every single night. Thank God for my grandmother. Like, she stepped up and she really helped my mom out. You know, it just, I was mad. Like, I was mad at the doctor because she didn't get the right treatment because she didn't have the money to get the right treatments to get, to get help. So, like, she was in the hospital 6 months out of the year. Could you imagine as a child not seeing your mom 6 months out of the year? You know, so like it's my grandmother really stepped up heavy, you know, took care of us and, you know, brought us in and, you know, really showed us the way, a better life than what I was going through, you know, living with my mother. My father was never there either, so.
Okay, wow. Okay, so let's pivot a little bit into your years as, because I know that we all have our times and moments in our life where we have our favorite years. And did you really see that you found yourself when you was in high school and you knew who you were, what you wanted to do and be, or was it in your later years during college? Did you find yourself then?
I found myself now, Queen. You know, as a human being, we go through different stages in life. And I like to use it as a diamond. So in life, you know, you go through, as a diamond is formed through fire and pressure.
Yeah.
I mean, through heat and pressure, right? So in life, you know, we go through a lot of pressure. We go through a lot of heat. And that's how a diamond is formed. So you get to a certain point in your life where you're tired of all the heat and all the pressure. And now you're ready to be cut. And now you're unbreakable. So I think now I'm at that point now at 32 because I've been through so much in my life, you know, being locked up, being homeless. I think the only thing I haven't been yet is the electric chair. I've been, that was about it. But other than that, I've been through everything in my life. So when you get to a certain point, you just unbreakable and you just, you can't really embrace heartache. You can't embrace being hurt. You can't embrace disappointment because you're used to it and you want to be successful, you know?
So I definitely believe crushed diamonds are still valuable. I definitely believe that diamonds in the dirt are still worthy. I believe that the diamond found in the bottom of the sewer, just because it has all this debris around it, has no devalued. It didn't devalue its worth. And I feel like we are all, in some cases, gems and diamonds. And we all have been in a pit somewhere. And someone or ourselves had to crawl up out of the pit, and we're still just as valuable. Sometimes people don't know who they are and they don't know the value or the worth of themselves. So So they continue to feel like they're carrying around all of this dirt. And that dirt happens to be the past, the history of the traumas that they had to face and overwhelming loss, right? You had at some point had to have discovered that you truly were able to do all kinds of things despite the pain. What was the worst time in your life where you had the most crushing of blow and felt that pain and forgot how valuable you were? Or did you always think that you were valuable?
Oh, I always thought I was valuable. You should always think you're valuable, because then if you don't, then...
Some people don't. Okay. Okay.
I think the crucial point in my life when I lost my mother, that's about, I mean, okay. When I lost my mother, but, you know,
yeah.
When I lose relationships, like when I lose, I don't, it hurt, but because we're human, you're going to feel pain, you're going to feel that hurt, but as long as you know your value and what you could bring to the world, what you could bring to the relationship, and once you raise your standards and you know who you are as a person, it really don't hurt you no more. Like I said, you just want to be successful. Like once you accomplish one goal in life, you want to see how far you can go. Like, well, I got it accomplished. Okay, we'll see how far I can go. You know, how much more can I accomplish in life? How far can I accomplish? You know, so that really drives you. You know.
Yeah, it does. So you have a few projects that you are working on, and I know that you are doing a couple of events, and you can promote them later when we get ready to get off. But what my question to you is that you seem to be a giver, because you give all the time to all those people that are around you, right? So when you decided that you was going to create your brand, and you decided that you was going to continue to motivate people, when did you first decide that you was actually going to go out on speaking engagements? And then what was the best speaking engagement? And then what was the worst one? What was the hardest, I should say? What was the hardest one for you so far?
I just did it, Queen. I just stepped out and just did it. I just wanted to do it. And, you know, if you sit down and procrastinate, you're never going to get it done. So I just did it. And I never look at anything hard, because life in general is hard. So you got to embrace that. I look at it as a challenge. And, you know, a life without pain and challenge is a life without growth. So I looked at it as a challenge. My first one was a challenge because it was like 50 people. And I wasn't really prepared for it. I kind of like, you know, just looked at it as, you know, I'm going to go in there and talk. Like, I'm going to go in there and tell them how it is. Like, I wasn't really prepared for it. So that was a challenging one. And then my second one I did, I went actually prepared for it. You know, I sat down, I talked to myself, I prepared for it. And I went in there, and it was a really great engagement. So each thing is a lesson. You know, it can't be hard. It's a lesson. If you fail, embrace it. You know, look at it as embrace the failure and sit down and reflect and ask yourself, what can you do better next time?
Right. Absolutely. Yeah, because we fall forward. We don't just fall down. We need to fall forward. And our failures are supposed to be those lessons that we learn, and they help us to get to the next level. What is the worst advice that you ever received?
Worst advice. When I was homeless, I'm about to say never, but yeah, when I was homeless, they wanted me to stop working, because when I was homeless, I was working, and they wanted me to stop working to get a voucher to get my own place to get out the shelter faster. And I told them, my counselor at the time told me that I should do that. I told him, no, I'm not gonna stop working for a voucher. Like, if y'all want me to get on government assistance, you crazy. Like, I'm not doing that. Like, nah, because the minute the government stopped those funds, my funds stopped. I really have my own money. So,
okay. What is the best advice you ever received?
told myself to just be great. I haven't really received, you know, I had people point to me and tell me that I'm a great speaker and I'm a great inspirational influence. But as far as like advice, I tell myself all the time that I just challenge myself, and you know, I'm not scared. I just put different goals, and I put big goals in front of me, and I just want to achieve it. You know, that's it. Like, I don't admire a multi-millionaire. I don't admire like all these people who big shot. I just admire myself, and I want to be on their level.
You know, so Will Smith says that the only person, at least that's who I heard it from, he said that the biggest competition is the one that's looking in the mirror. Do you agree?
Oh, definitely. I definitely agree with that, because it's you versus you. And Will Smith is my guy. I love Will Smith. I love Will Smith. He's definitely a great speaker, too.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he is. He is a good speaker. So when you decided that you wanted to go into creating your brand, did you have any school training for that? Did you take any classes, courses, or did you just decide that you was going to put this brand together and just go ahead and went ahead and did it?
I did everything on my own, including no school lessons or nothing. My website, I did everything. Literally just playing on my iPad. You know, that's what you can do. Like, Most men should do that. A lot of guys don't do that. They go get the new PS5 and like, hey bro, you got a new PS5? Hey, nah, bro, I got some barcodes I just downloaded. You know, my iPad. You know, so that's
what I do. Okay. So I understand. So you was just focused on what you was trying to do, not on playing video games and other kind of stuff. So I get it. I understand. Okay, this might be a question for you. Hold on. CyberShots is in the building. CyberShots is my partner. We do digital flowers together. He, I, and Guru, and DJ Lala. So this is CyberShots. He's a podcaster as well.
Upstylistic, Red Sable, what's going on? Welcome to the app. First and foremost, you're in good hands with Red Sable. You know what I mean? And it is always a pleasure to meet someone fulfilling their goals and taking their journey and never giving up. You know what I'm saying? That right there within itself is motivation.
Thank you, brother. I appreciate you, man. I would love to go on your podcast sometimes too, brother, and just collaborate, man. You just get the message out, man, that, you know, is always a chance to do better and be better. I don't care if you're in jail and you got out of jail and you got to start all over again. It's always a chance to do better and be better. We got breath in your body. When God give you breath to get up every single morning, there's always a chance to do better and be better every single day.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. So since you mentioned podcasting, let's talk a little bit about your show. Tell us about your show, your podcast. Where are you? Where's your show at? And how can we listen?
My podcast is on Apple, Google, iHeartRadio. It's called Sean Jackson Motivation. And I haven't really done any podcasts with like individuals yet. But I just been using my podcast to promote my local artists so far. Like, I got a guy who came up to me and he's young. He's only 22, and he's like, man, I want to be great. Like, I want to be great. Like, I love rapping, and like, I see that you're empowering people, and I just want to be down with you. I was like, he's like, whatever you need, man. I do music. I do backgrounds. Like, I do all of it. Whatever you need, man, I got you. I was like, all right, bro. All right, let me see what you got, man. So he did a song for me that I put on SoundCloud. Well, I put on my podcast. It's on SoundCloud, iHeart, and Apple. And he did a song for me, and it was like, it was really dope just to hear like a young white rapper just come out and start rapping like that. Like, man, you remind me of Eminem, bro. I like that. Okay.
So, okay, you got a little Eminem thing going on. Okay. Yeah. So are you managing him or?
So a little bit, Queen, a little bit. I try to get him in the right mindset as far as rapper mindset. Okay. Because I follow Tupac. Tupac's one of my favorite rappers. And I tell them all the time, I tell all these rappers that if you want to be a rapper, have a Tupac mentality. You know, because look at Tupac. Tupac didn't go on, and he had some of the best records still out there that's hitting. You know, he still got some of the best records. He did movies. He had a killer, sharp mentality. Even though he had bad character, he still had a great work ethic. You know what I mean?
Yeah, he did. He's very, very intelligent. Very talented and very intelligent. So yeah, so Tupac is your favorite rapper. Okay, that's good. That's good. And so your podcast right now, you said you haven't done new episodes, but people can go and listen to what you have that's there. What else will they find that you talk about on your show?
I did a few podcasts when I was with my ex. I let her daughter do a podcast because she has endeavors of being a YouTuber. She's 9 years old, so I'm a big influence on. I love kids, and I want to inspire kids to be great early, so when they get our age, they'll be phenomenal. You know. So yeah. I let her do like 2 or 3 shows on the podcast, and it was just dope hearing her voice on the podcast just to talk. And she's only 9 years old, so. She was talking about slime and stuff like that. Like, it was cute, you know?
Oh, that's sweet. Aw. That's good. I love it. So, okay. So, you said Apple, iHeart, and
SoundCloud.
What was the other place?
SoundCloud. Okay. Google Podcasts.
Okay. Okay, good. Good. So, the podcasting community is massive, but there are some really, really cool people that I've met over the years that I consider like friends and family. So have you been able to connect to people in that space?
As far as like friends and family?
Yeah, that you consider that you're comfortable with, because it's the way when I started podcasting, it was really community-based. It was like everybody helping everyone because we were all trying to figure it out. None of us knew what we were doing, right? So we were all just helping each other, even though every single one of us had our own different type of mission or vision for our singular podcast. We collectively shared everybody else's stuff. We would collectively go and root for somebody and help them to get up the charts. It was just this whole thing on this platform called Anchor.fm that was just, it was completely different. Now it's one way, but it wasn't always like that. So I'm saying that to ask you, do you have you built any built-in community units within the podcast space or the social media space like of Clubhouse or anything like that? That helps you to keep you going because we all need like support, you know?
I mean, I do have a few people. You know, I have Jennifer, who's my, she's actually the host. I'm her co-host. But, you know, I have her. She's been on my behind, like Sean, you know, your podcast. And then she's doing a hell of a job, you know, just promoting my podcast and getting the different people, the speakers, the performers, let them know that I have a podcast and that, you know, we can give them a 5-minute interview of my podcast. So, like, she's been a big part of that. John, my pops, he's been on me too about that. So, like, a few people been on me about my podcast as well. So, yeah, definitely, Queen.
Okay. Okay, cool. Now, John, your father, is he a podcaster?
John, he's not my real father. John Boss X, he's on Clubhouse. I'm not sure you know him.
Oh, okay. I've heard of him. I've been in some of his his show, his clubs before. So yeah, no, he's very good. He's very good. I don't. Sometimes those clubs they run for hours. They on in the middle of the night. And one day I was on. It was like 3 o'clock in the morning, and he was still going strong. And I was like, oh my god. But yeah, he's very, very knowledgeable.
Yeah, he called me his son. That's my pop, so I call him Pop.
Oh, okay. That's sweet. So I really, really appreciate everything that you're doing, what you're bringing to the community. When you do your your motivational speaking? Are you connecting more to your speeches towards gentlemen or to women or both?
I'm trying to reach the world, Queen. I want to reach everybody. Like Nas, for example. Nas was a great rapper, and his number one message was he wanted his message to be heard, his voice to be heard around the world. And once that was, once he accomplished that, you see, you won't hear Nas like that no more. Like, he accomplished what he wanted. And, like, that's what I want to do. I want to be the voice of my generation. I want to reach multiple people, not just white people, black people. I want to reach Chinese people. I want to reach the young folk. I want to reach the youth. I want to reach, you know, old people. I want to reach everybody, you know, because everybody's going through it, like young, old, fat, skinny, doesn't matter who it is. Like, somebody's going through it in life, and they need somebody to really pick them up and lift them up, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's great. I think that that is definitely achievable. I think that you're already doing that. You're already reaching. I mean, I've been to some of your rooms, and I see there are all kinds of people in your room gravitating towards what you're saying. You don't really say a lot, but because of everybody else speaking, but your rooms are getting bigger. When I first started going to your rooms, you were just starting out, but now they're huge. So that's a credit to you and what you're doing, and your energy, the energy that you bring. You respond to everyone as queen or king. You are compassionate and kind and patient, and I've never heard anything negative or crazy come from you at all. And I like to be in spaces where I can get to know the person that I am sharing that same space with. And so you allow people to get to know you, so you don't hold anything back or anything like that. You're not putting on any airs or anything. People don't come to your place, your space, a clubhouse, and feel uncomfortable or not heard, because you give everyone the same type of opportunity. So I think what you're doing is fantastic.
And that's the best part of life, is just being authentic. You know, you got to be yourself. Absolutely. Through in and throughout. And, like, just when you're authentic in life, through in and throughout, it sticks to you. Like, it really, you become that person, like, and it's just natural. It's just natural. You know, it becomes natural.
Oh, yeah. You could tell if it was fake. I could tell if it was fake, and I don't feel that from you.
Okay. I just want to be great, Queen. Like, I tell people all the time, you know, we're no God-given talent to nobody, but you just got to tell yourself, I'm going to be great for myself. I'm going to be great for my kids. I'm going to be great for my family. And I promise you, you will see a whole different level. You see a whole different animal in you, because nothing will stop you or slow you down. You have a relentless effort, because I tell myself that every single day.
Mm-hmm. Okay. We got a couple of messages. Let's see who's calling. All right. We are starting with a gentleman by the name of Edge.
What's going on to the panel? I just wanted to ask a question to the young guy, to the gentleman. As far as speaking is concerned, what is your demographic?
Before you answer that, he left another one, so that might be the part two.
Hey, once again, elevate your mind. Here's another question to the gentleman. Who is your mentor as far as speaking is concerned? And if you have a mentor, do you have one, or do you have two, or do you have any?
So,
okay, did you get that?
Yeah, I did, Queen. Mm-hmm. So I have a lot of mentors. My demographic is just reaching a wide range of people. And, like, my mentors, like, I listen to motivational stuff every single day, not to motivate myself, but to empower my mind. And so I listen to a lot of Tony Robbins. That's my favorite guy. I listen to David Goggins, Eric Thomas. Coach Payne is new, a lot of people probably don't know about Coach Payne, but he's really good because he lost his mom and his dad. So, like, a video that he did is called When It Hurts. It really resonated with me. So, like, I listened to Coach Payne. Kevin Hart did a video. Tupac did a video. You know, Kevin Hart actually did a video with Tony Robbins. Tyrese did a motivational video. So, like, I listen to everybody. You know, I'm more tuned with the motivational stuff every single day because to be a great speaker, you got to, like, listen to speakers and kind of, like, see how they're doing things and kind of, like, not be like them, be your own way, but see how they're doing things. You know, to be the best, you got to follow the best. So.
Okay. Very good. All right, so he has another question. There we go.
And so now, my other question is this. Do you plan on elevating and going from being just a motivational speaker to becoming a professional speaker?
Oh, yeah, definitely, definitely. That's my dream. That's my goal. I'm definitely going to accomplish that. I actually had a few people on LinkedIn reach out to me on being a professional. I feel like that's a great opportunity to be a servant, to be a voice, to really help the world out, you know, take full advantage of that opportunity. So, yeah, definitely, brother.
Okay. Absolutely is an opportunity to be able to reach people. Professional speaking is a journey. It doesn't happen overnight. It's a process. So I think that you're going about it the right way. You're listening to different people and then you're applying your own style. That's the way you should be able to do it. So I think that's a good look.
Exactly.
Okay, so you are actually creating some platforms in order to have people come and speak. Do you want to promote some things?
Well, me and Jennifer, Mahaja, I think I said that right. She's going to kill me. But me and her, we're doing a global summit. It's a healing global. It's the second annual global healing summit. She did the first one last year, and it was going to be a small one this year, but we collaborated. And you know me, I go big or go home, because when you go big, you attract big. When you go small, you attract small. So I said, let's do it big. Let's do a three-day summit. Let's do a global. You know, we got people in the UK. Me and her both got friends in the UK. We got Gerson, a speaker out of the UK. So he's going to speak on the summit. We got speakers in Africa. We got like a prince, actual African prince. He's going to speak in the summit. Mm-hmm. You know, we got Grace Holden. Jennifer knows an actor who played in Law and Order. He's going to speak in the summit. So, you know, we just here trying to, and to me, it's not really about the big names, because like I told her, when you bring in the big names, you really taking away from the other people who are trying to come up and make a name for themselves, you know? So I'm all about people who really trying to evolve in life, you know, because evolution is the way of life. If you're not evolving, then what's your purpose? So that's the gist of the summit, because we're in a pandemic, Queen. You know what I'm saying? Well, like, we home, and, you know, COVID going on. A lot of people are down in the dump. So if they're able to get online, a virtual summit, and you know, whatever it is, like, it could be speaking, because we got speakers, we got actors, we got performers, we got poets, you know. So, because everybody has a gift to give to the world, God gave everybody a gift to bless to the world, and you just gotta find what you're good at and present it, you know.
I agree. The summit sounds amazing, and you sent me something for another. I can't remember the name of it right now, but it's an application to sign up for speaking at another huge event that you're doing. What was that one called again?
Oh, Success Fest. It was pretty cool. I loved that opportunity because I took full of it. I sent them a video, because you guys sent them like a little snippet of you speaking real quick, and they got submitted. So I get up at 3 a.m. every single day. So I sent them a video at like 5:30 a.m. And I was like, 5:30 a.m. I'm going to the gym. And, you know, I just had some motivational stuff. And the dude texted back immediately. He was like, man, I love your voice. It was like, the committee chose you to speak. It was like, please select which one you want to speak. And then I had sent him some more stuff. And I had won this competition because I had shared a link a lot of times. And mm-hmm. I got a photo that they're doing for me to go on the page on their website. So it's pretty cool.
Oh, that's good. Very good. That's good. Yeah, it does. It looks amazing. It looks like it's going to be huge as well. Hold on 1 second. We got a couple of calls. Okay. Okay. Let's go with Cyber, and then we have Edge.
Most definitely kept catching good energy, you know what I'm saying, a good vibe from you. So I followed you on Instagram and also on here. And, yeah, man, we can collaborate, do something. You know, Red Sable and I, we do a lot of stuff together. So, yeah, I'm glad that she brought you out here, you know what I'm saying, and introduced me to you. That's what's up.
Definitely, man. Blessings. Thank you, King. I appreciate you a lot.
Okay, so now we have the brother Edge.
How long have you actually been motivating people? How long have you actually been motivating and speaking to people? If you don't mind me asking.
My whole entire life, brother. My whole entire life, King, literally. You know, from my mom, when she had sickle cell, you know, I had to inspire her, let her know that, you know, it's going to be a better day. She can get through it. I cried with her. You know, my relationships, you know, I inspire, if you're my lady, you know, I inspire you to be great. Because if I'm trying to be great, well, I'm great. If I'm great, I want my lady to be great. So I'm going to inspire my lady to be great. You know, if you my friend, mm-hmm. I have family, I have friends. But if we family and we hang out a lot and we talk and we in tune, I'm going to inspire you. Like I just love doing that in general. Just who I am as a person, man. Because like I said, when you go through so much pain and suffering, your own self in your life, and you just get to a point when you can't be broken no more, man. You just want to be great. And I feel like once you get over that mountain, it's very vital to reach your hand over the mountain and help somebody else out, you know? I tell people all the time, it's not about being a motivational speaker, it's about being a servant. Anytime you have direct contact with people, you have a chance to you have a chance to change their life.
Literally. I agree.
Anytime you have direct contact with people, you have a chance to change their life. It's not about motivation, it's a servant. I'm being a server right now, you know?
Mm-hmm. Okay, we have another one from Edge.
My other question to you is, how many books do you read a month? And are you a big fan of personal development?
I don't read no books. I just listen to a lot of motivational stuff. And I'm a big person on personal development. I really feel like, I tell people all the time, working on yourself is like a full-time job. you gotta fully commit to yourself, you know, mm-hmm. to really get past those bad days. You gotta fully commit to yourself, literally. And in order to, mm-hmm. you gotta get your mind and your body in tune with one another. And how you do that? By fully committing to yourself.
Mm. Oh, yeah. And it takes time. I mean, you have your whole life. And God willing, whatever his purpose is for you, you're going to be here for many, many, many years. So you will always be learning about yourself. Always. Okay. We have another one from Edge.
Excuse the music in the background. I'm in a grocery store. But I want to ask you a question. Do you have your story, you know, done? Like, have you put together your story and the brand? What is the brand that you're promoting?
I'm actually writing a book right now. My story is getting put in the book. And my brand I'm promoting is Upstylish LLC, the new style. And, you know, the whole brand is to up your standards. You got to raise your standards in life in order to have a great life. Like, for example, like, if you around friends that's negative, like, I don't care if it's childhood friends and they're not bringing value to your life, you know, you gotta make that sacrifice. So my brand is all about getting people to up their standard, up style, you know, and just have that mentality of, you know, I'm going to be great. I am phenomenal. You know, be phenomenal or be forgotten.
Oh yeah. So when you first meet a person, they have an impact. You get a certain feeling from them, right? You get a certain energy that kind of floats between you and that person that you're meeting for the first time. And you can tell whether or not you are going to vibe with this person or not. And you could tell whether or not this person is going to be someone that you can actually learn from or not, right? So in your journey, have you met people that you instantly clicked with? And are you still maintaining those relationships? Or did you have to let some people go because of whatever energy, it just didn't work for you?
I definitely let people go. You know, it's all about raising your standards. If people are not trying to go where you're going in life, you got to make that sacrifice. Mm-hmm. You know, mm-hmm. It sucks, but that's the way of life. You got to evolve yourself. Again, I go back to kids. If you got kids on this earth, you can't allow anybody to hold you down. So I definitely cut people off. And it's all about eye contact. If somebody can't look you in your eye and talk to you, you're not real. You know, mm-hmm. I'm all about, if you talk to me face to face, I'm going to look you right in your eye and talk to you, mm-hmm. and tell you so you can see how real I'm being. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Okay. That's good. Have you ever been at a speaking engagement so far? Because I know you have a lot of other things that you're juggling. But so far in the speaking engagements that you've been in, have you been in any that made you uncomfortable, that you did not want to proceed and speak there?
I haven't. You know, I haven't. I haven't. And I don't think I will ever do that, because I just love pointing to people. And I just bring that. I just have a big old smile on my face as soon as I walk in the room.
Okay. I can see that. I actually saw, I think you have a YouTube page where I saw it. And you were speaking to a few people. I think you told me it was a homeless shelter or something. It looked like a classroom. But you were speaking and they were very quiet. They didn't say anything. They were just watching you. And then you just started applauding them and thanking them and telling them to applaud themselves because they showed up.
Yeah.
What made you do that?
Because if you really want change, you must hear it. You know, I took it all the time. So, and they showed up, you know, and they wanted the change, because that was optional. That wasn't mandatory. You know, they could have stayed in their rooms, mm-hmm. and not showed up, but they all showed up, you know, so they really want to change. Mm-hmm. So that's why I said, you know, give you guys yourself a round of applause, because you showed up. That's mm-hmm. the first step. If you really want change, you must hear it. You guys just showed up.
Well, I love the video. I think it's fabulous. You did really, really well. And they listened to you. They sat there and they were engaged. So that's a good thing. And speaking isn't always an easy thing to do when you are doing it for the first time and there's all these different type of people, and some of them are engaged and then others start talking or playing on their phones or just messing around trying to distract you. Because maybe it hasn't happened to you. If it has happened to you, what did you do in order to refocus their attention? And if it didn't, what would you do?
I just keep it authentic and just, you know, give myself, I just relate myself to the situation. And then once you do that, you get their attention, you know, because you can't just walk in there like you high and mighty. If you can really tell them Absolutely. Your story and how you can relate to them, You know, a lot of people mm-hmm. sit there and listen, like, wow, you've been there. So how did you get there? How did you get to where you at now? So, like, a lot of them really going to listen because you've been mm-hmm. in their shoes, you know?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, and I agree with that. I think it's really, I'm trying to think of a word. I think it's commendable. There it is. I think it's commendable that you came from where you came from and was able to turn that around for you. But I'm just a huge faith-driven person, and I know that God helped you to turn those corners, because those corners was rough, and you could have just given up, or you could have gotten to a fight over the whole situation and done more than a day in jail. So I think that it's commendable that you was able to do that in the situation that you was in, and to turn it around so much that when people are listening to you now and they are focusing on what you're saying, they would have no clue that your past was what it was. You know what I'm saying? So I think that as you continue to go through your journey, there's going to be some more layers, because you're still shedding old skin. So there's going to be some more layers that's going to be removed from you, and you're going to find the core of your greatness, the core of your brilliance as time continues to go on, because there's still work being done in you, and you have yet to even scratch the surface of where it is that you, in your mind, you see. But in God's eye, he already knows that he has you situated and set up for something even greater than you can imagine. You know that, right?
I appreciate that, Queen.
Okay. All right, we got another message. It's from Ed.
Brother, I've been listening to you for a minute. I've been asking questions. And I want to say this. I commend you on your journey. The one thing that you said that let me know that you were genuine about what you're talking about is the fact that you said you're not a motivational speaker. You're here to serve. I commend you on that. There's a lot of fake and phony people out here that's only doing it for the money. That right there let me know that this is about passion, and you're about the people. And as Eric Thomas always say, when you pursue your passion, the profits will come. I salute you. The second thing you said was, when she asked you, how do you get their attention? You said, you find common ground. You tell your story. That's the thing that connects you to them and connects them to you. Brother, you on your way, bro. You the real deal, bro.
Oh, man. Thank you so much, King. I appreciate you a lot, man. We all the real deal, man. We gonna eat together, man. We gonna serve together. You know, we gonna be the next Eric Thomas, Les Browns out here, man. Mm-hmm. So thank you a lot, King. I appreciate mm-hmm. you, man. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that was beautiful. Thank you, Edge. Thank you for sharing that and telling him that. I appreciate that. Everyone, thank you for listening. Who has joined and don't know what you're listening to, I am Red Sable, and this is Visionary Views. And our special guest is Mr. Sean Jackson, known as The Refresher. So thank you all. All right. I want to move on into, what is your next big thing? I know you got the whole speaking engagements coming up with the summits and things like that. But you are aspiring to become a bigger speaker. Are you seeing yourself in the broadcast space? Where do you see your vision going?
Wherever God leads me, Queen. You know, I just want to serve people and help people. And, you know, I'm not really for the fame and, you know, stuff like mm-hmm. that. You know, like King was saying, you know, the prophet's going to come, but I'm here just mm-hmm. to help people and let people know that, you know, even though we get up every single day and we do our daily routine, we go to work, we have our bad mm-hmm. days. You know, we still have family members getting locked up. We still got family members that's mm-hmm. dying every single day. My cousin just died Saturday. He got shot down in the club. So we still got family members that's dying. But we still mm-hmm. got to get up and we still gotta get it done. Cause if we don't kill it, our family don't eat. You know?
Yeah. I'm sorry to hear that about your cousin too. So yeah, no, and you're right. We do have to keep going because life keeps going. And we can't stand still because we won't be getting the work done. We all have our own individual races to run, but we have to pull people with us in order to get it done, right? I don't believe in leaving people behind when they don't become hindrance. Now, if they are hindering you, then you have to let some people go. But I definitely believe in bringing people with you who's going to help you to lift those tides and who's going to help you to row that boat when you're in the middle of a storm and you have no clue because you're too exhausted to lift another thing. You have to have people with you. So I pray that you continue to be surrounded by people who will continue to lift you, because there will come a time where God is going to always send us people. We have to decide on whether or not we're going to receive them based on their generosity, or if we're going to sense that they're here just to try to take from the situation and not give to the situation. So I feel like you're going to continue to surround yourself with people who are servants just as yourself, who will serve no matter what type of the situation that they are in. And I relate to that. I relate to the whole thing. I've never been in jail, but I have been homeless. And I've been homeless for a lot longer than I even care to think about. But I've also been in a lot of abusive situations, and I don't know how I was able to do a lot of the things that I was able to do unless I credit it to God. So I know it was only God that got me through. So I know it was only God that got you through as well. So I want to find out from you is this, would you want it different? If you had a choice to be able to walk through a door and that door will lead you to a whole different type of situation that you never had the past that you had before, would you want to be able to wipe the whole slate clean and start it over? Would you want to do that?
Definitely no, because, you know, I yes. wouldn't be there now, because through pain mm-hmm. comes, you know, I tell everybody, you want to take your test and make your testimony and make mm-hmm. your message. Mm-hmm. And I would never
do that. I'm so happy you said that.
Because, like, I have kids, and, you know, whenever my son faced anything in life, I could tell him to get through it because your father got through mm-hmm. it. You know, and I can sit down mm-hmm. and tell him a story that, you know, that I've been through and, you know, that mm-hmm. I got through it, and that's going to empower my son to get through it, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yes, I'm so glad that you said that, because you're right. I wouldn't change anything that happened, and I've lost a lot. I've lost family, I've lost limbs, I've lost functionality, but I would not change it because I wouldn't be who I am. And if I'm not who I am, then who would I be if I go through a door that turns me into something else? I wouldn't want that. So, yeah, so thank you for saying that. We got two messages for you. Okay. And they're both from Ed. Hold on.
Do me a favor. When you get a chance, I want you to write William Winfield. William Winfield. Write that. It's a solid brother. It's a servant. He's one of those real deal brothers that really you want to have in your network. I'm big on building networks with authentic and genuine people when it comes to being able to take what's in your mind and articulate it in a way that you impact people's lives. William Winfield. He's not just one of your fellow brothers in the arena that we all operate in, but he is truly a brother's keeper, man. Solid brother, man. And he stay humble, man. In spite of all that he's had, the success. William Winfield, man. Check him out on Facebook. Reach out to him, brother. I'm telling you. You should collaborate with. He humble like you, man. And humility, bro, that's the new currency.
Yes, sir. I definitely wrote him now, man. Thank you so much, man. I'm going to reach out William Winfield. Thank you so much, man. I'm going to tap in on Facebook and see if we can collaborate, you know, see where we can go from there. It's all about growing and evolving. I tell everybody, we mm-hmm. all lions, and lions travel
and a pride. They travel in a pack. They have a pride. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I'm being in the right pride. You know, you just got to get in the right pride and grow and evolve mm-hmm. with your pride.
Okay, I agree. All right, so we're going to wind down right now because I have to move on to the next thing that I have to do. I want to thank you so much for spending your time with me today. It is, you are just super, super dope. The refresher, you're super, super dope. You're going to do great things, young king. Well, let me rephrase. You are going to continue to do great things, young king. You are. And I look forward to it. I hope I get a front row seat to it all. but if I do not, just send me a text, something to just say, hey, queen, you know, this is going on, so I can root for you from wherever I am. Okay?
And I got you, queen. I got you. Oh, we in tune now, so definitely I'm going to have you help me get my podcast going so I can bring you my podcast.
Yes. Yes, I would definitely be there. No question. Just tell me when. I'll be there. Thank you so much again. Do you want to promote anything else before we sign out?
Yeah, definitely. If you guys have a gift that you want to, you know, show the world, you know, I strongly suggest you guys join this summit, this global summit, and, you know, just help me, help Jennifer, help Sable, help all of us get our message out and change the world. I love you guys always. Again, guys, let's make a difference, you know?
Thank you so much. I appreciate you. I appreciate everyone here. I'm going to play this last message, but we won't be able to answer it. But let me see who this is. This is Edge again.
This goes out to Red Sable. Red Sable, this is one of the few interviews that I've had, that I've heard on this app, that is full of value. Full of value. Full. And I've noticed that the shows that have real, live, authentic content and that's valuable, they don't have that many people on there. They don't have that. Every now and then you'll have a show. But I want to shout out to Red Sable. Very professional. Very, very innovative, refreshing interview with the phenomenal brother to your right. And listen, this kept me on the road as I on my way home, man. I was in the grocery store. Very few shows catch my attention like this, man. This is extraordinary. My hat goes off. I commend you. Salute to you, Red Sable.
Thank you so much. I appreciate that, Edge. I really, really appreciate the kind words. And I'm just doing what I do. I share my platform with people who have a story to tell, and a genuine story from their tests to their from their trials to their triumphs, from the pain to the purpose. That's what I do. It's always been a part of who I am, always, my entire life. I'm a giver. I'm a servant. That's what I do. So thank you, The Refresher, again. I appreciate you. I appreciate you, Edge, Cyber, Tanika Drake, and whoever else I may have missed. Thank you, thank you, thank you. You are all super, super dope, amazing energy. And yeah, we dropped a lot of gems. Well, we received a lot of gems, because I know I can't even keep up with Mr. The Refresher over here. But yeah, we received a lot today.
Thank you.
I'm gonna let you go. Yeah, honey, thank you. No, thank you, because I mean, hey, you do what you do, you keep doing what you do, and I will keep on following you and popping into your clubs and, you know, sharing some of my faith and wisdom with you as well, okay?
We're definitely going to bring it back, y'all. If y'all enjoyed this conversation, and man, if you kept y'all in tune, we definitely going to bring it back. You know, I love inspiring people and keep people in tune with the message, man. So definitely, Quinn, we're going to bring this back again. I got y'all, man. I love y'all people. Always, it's a refresher. Mm-hmm. Remember that.
Absolutely. So, yeah, we could definitely come back and do this again. Absolutely. All right, darling, you go ahead and do what you need to do. I know the babies are calling you and wondering where dad is. So you go ahead.
Sounds good.
All right, honey. Thank you.
Always.
Love, 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 and blessings, everyone. Have a blissfully blessed and beautiful day. I'll talk to you all soon. Take care of you.
Okay, my beloveds, wasn't that amazing? I really, really enjoyed it, and I hope that you enjoyed it as well. It was very inspiring and very revealing, right? So we're going to move on into a short playlist, and that'll be it for the day, okay? So marinate on the words that you heard today from the refresher. Marinate on the responses that you received from the call-ins, and marinate on what you think you can do in order for you to change yourself in a way that makes you want to be great, as the refresher would say. Okay? And as I would say, and I say, whatever it is that you're going to do, you do it with love. Okay? All right, let's begin. And these songs are going to be upbeat, and they are going to be inspirational too. So you know how I do. There's a little bit of gospel and gospel hip hop, and yeah. So let's get started. Thank you.
28:1 says that the wicked flee when no man pursues, but the righteous are as bold as a lion. It's a new day. It's time out for simple religion and tradition. It's time for a real relationship. Kingdom business, a kingdom movement. We're getting fear out of the body. We're getting hate out of the body. Put the truth in their face when they hear the music, doing shows, going through the motions. Uncle Rich, don't do that. I'd rather be real about what I live. 100% is all I can give. All I can do is be me. All I can do is be free. Calamity, poor like a fee, money hungry. If I don't have hope, what else can I be? High school, 5 years. Teacher said I'd be nothing. Now I'm on the billboard chart, on the radio, doing something black, bluffing. Turned in my religion, fought into Christian living. No matter sinning, I'm winning. But when I mess up, I'm forgiven. But when I mess up, I'm forgiven. Worship on my crew, we worship hard and keep it moving. Born free from the institution. Scream out, viva revolution. We're getting hypocrisy out of the body. It's a new creation. Revolution music. Boldness in our everyday life. Boldness on our job. Boldness in our walk with Christ. If you scared, say you scared. There's strength in the midst of the struggle. There's peace in the middle of the storm. We're looking for front lines. It's about to be spiritual warfare, and you gotta be ready to fight. It's time to get a praise out of your pain. Praise until you pass out. Get ready. It's about that time. This Tony got it, and I'm bold.
Lord knows I've been sinning, and I'ma work on that. Let Jesus take the wheel, I put my horse on that. I've been blind, but now I see. That is blood, is what I need. Lord knows I've been sinning, and I'ma work on that. Let Jesus take the wheel, I put my horse on the I am blind, but now I see. That's blood is what I need.
Yes, that was Uncle Reese. Oh, that song is a bop. We are moving on.
I want to talk to you. I want to talk to you. Just wait.
You on this earth. Had to put in prayer, felt I was cursed. Always tell myself it could have been worse. Never going back, I broke the reverse. It come from my soul, no need to rehearse. A lot of time I was in need of work. Talk to God like I needed to work. Dropped the line like I needed it first. But I was being selfish, you know this don't affect a lot of people. I was being careless, took a break and stepped away. I'm coming back when I get ready. I know this breaks people into pieces, but I ain't gonna let it.
Yo, Blaze, you crazy for this one. Hey, all the champions out there feel so good. Hey, I said it feels so good.
Can't be racing to no early grave, I'm cool with just pacing. I can drop at any given time, I'm holding my aces. I see disappointment all in their faces. The turtles still cross the finish line. We'd embrace the bar so many times, it's only right they give me mine. Diamond by myself, together we really shine. As long as I keep putting my faith and trust in God, I know that everything will be fine. Built for a real stand up God, ain't never breaking my kind. I believe I can do anything, ain't never changing my mind. Life's all about patience, take it one day at a time. All about patience, taking one day at a time.
Okay, my beloveds, y'all know how I feel about that song, Kirk Franklin and Little Baby. We win. Yes, we do. Collectively, we win. We win when we are standing still. When we stand still together in unity, we win. We win with love. We win with peace. We win with encouragement. And we win with positivity. And we win with prosperity that will come when we continue to be productive in our movements when they are done from a point of honor and trust and truth. Let's move on. Mally Music.
I'm blessed. Anybody in here blessed? I'm blessed. Wishes make you feel like less.
Anybody in here blessed?
I'm blessed.
Anybody in here blessed?
I'm blessed. Wait, get your phone, text your people, they should. All the problems and your needs if you just. Lawyer, doctor, anything if you just. You got some questions about some things you just. You a king, be the king, you just. A proper comfort for the queens if they. Live in favor, see the dream. Get your phone, text your people, they should. So you're in the shadows by yourself. You just underwater and not reaching out for help. Whoa, only wave you can't get over is your own. That tsunami blocking passage to the throne. Phone dying, worry how you getting home. Preparation isolated and alone. Pull up like a Uber, hallelujah. Any type of music that'll move you. And we don't really care what you're doing, we just walk up in the room like. Like glass.
Anybody in here blessed?
I'm blessed.
Anybody in here blessed?
I'm blessed. Wait, get your phone, text your people, they should ask Christ. All the problems and your needs if you just ask Christ. Lawyer, doctor, anything if you just ask Christ. You got some questions about some things, you just ask Christ. You a king, he the king, you just ask Christ. A proper comfort for the queens if they ask nice. Live in favor, see the dream, ask Christ.
Get your phone, text your people, they should. When you're in the shadows by yourself, you just underwater and not reaching out for help. Whoa, only wave you can't get over is your own. That tsunami blocking passage to the throne. Phone dying, worry how you getting home. Preparation isolated and alone. Pull up like a Uber, hallelujah. Any type of music that'll move you. And we don't really care what you're doing, we just walk up in the room like.
Is anybody in here blessed?
I'm blessed.
Is anybody in here blessed?
I'm blessed.
Is anybody in here blessed?
I'm blessed. I'm blessed. Feel you're in the shadows by yourself. You just underwater and not reaching out for help. Whoa, only wave you can't get over is your own. That tsunami blocking passage to the throne. Phone dying, worry how you getting home. Preparation isolated and alone. Pull up like a Uber, hallelujah. Any type of music that'll move. I'm blessed. I'm blessed. I'm blessed. Season wishes make you feel like last. I'm blessed. I'm blessed. I'm blessed. Yo, yo,
God is good.
Okay, beloveds, moving on. This is Lecrae. Well, that was Mally Music with Blessed. Y'all know how I feel about Mally Music. If you don't, now you do. Moving on to Lecrae with Broke.
With the coco, never had to hold up the stove with the fofo. Never had the dough kicked in by the feds when I'm laying in the bed on a bread that I'm gon' blow. But I do know what it feel like to go to school with the knockoff shoes, eating free lunch, trying to act all cool. But you better know that we paid our dues. Never would I trade that, cause it made me better. Could've made me bitter. Can't buy that struggle, can't name no figure. But it made me richer. Yeah, being broke made me rich. And being low made you quit.
Been staying on sit right. I do it for my folk trying to get by. Came through the struggle with my head high. Being broke, and you know what it feel like. I said, being broke made me rich. Being broke made me rich. Being broke made me rich.
Being broke made me rich. And I keep the stove high so it cook right. If everybody eating, that's a good night. And I had to take a loss while I took flight. Hard times made for a good life. I said, being broke made me rich. Being broke.
Money may have made me richer, but the struggle got me richer than I ever been. Learn to hustle, use your muscle, learn to grind and keep your mind up on the future, man. We came out them trenches, government assistance in the beginning. Keep them cans for the pennies. We saving that grease after dinner. Now they counting all my pennies, counting all my figures, all up in my business, man. Now they watching what I'm spending, wonder what I got and wonder how I get it, man. I was balling for I had a dollar, being empty-handed made me stupid rich. Rich and loyalty can't pay the lawyer fee, but it's all good, it's why I pitching it.
I'm gonna stand on sit right. I do it for my folk trying to get by. Came through the struggle with my head high. Being broke, then you know what it feel like. I said being broke made me rich. Being broke made me rich. Being broke made me rich.
Being broke made me rich. Gotta keep the stove high so it cook right. If everybody eating, that's a good night. Now I gotta take a loss while I took flight. Hard times made for a good life. I said being broke made me rich. Being broke made me rich. Being broke made me rich. Being broke made me rich.
Working it out for my good. Working it out for my good. This pain won't last, the storm will pass. You are my God and you're working it, working it, working it out for my good. 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 This pain won't last, the storm will pass. I know. You are my God and you're working it, working it, working it out for my good. I love you, God. I am called into your purpose. You are my God. You do everything for a purpose, on purpose. I know, you are for me, yeah. You have never felt me yet. And just when I thought I was on my way out of here, your perfect love came through, cast away my fears. So I'ma give you all the glory.
Friday, holy moly, working it out for my victory, yeah. I was racing in the misery, car spin out, did a 180, now I'm racing the United Smith to be working it out, they can't figure it out, how did all of my pain turn to joy, should have been dead, but he kept me instead, gave me peace in the midst of the storm, working it out for my window, dancing in the rain like it's tango, keep life as hard, just looked at the gun, now you know why I shot it like fuego, bing,
working it out for my good, 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 yeah. This pain won't last, the storm will pass. I know you are my God, and you're working it, working it, working it out for my good, working it out for my good, working it out for my good. You're working it out for my good, working it out for my good. This pain won't last, the storm will pass. I know you are my God.
See his blessings, got no time for stressing, don't believe in failures in my life, it's only lessons, they just making room for what I'm on now, I don't got a clue, but I know the one who does know how, oh wow, it's like I'm learning the game with the maker I already know now, destiny has my name, no it's coming, it'll never go,
I know that we all gonna be alright, we gon' make it through if it takes us all night, no matter what the odds may bring our way, I can see the blessings coming our way, yeah, 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 blessings on blessings, yeah, I can see the blessings coming our way, our way, our way. Blessings on blessings, yeah, I can see the blessings coming our way.
I can't say that life's been perfect or complain, cause life's been worth it. And all because of who he is working. I'll be working out for my God. And no more living in that fear, no more tears, and no, no. Oh, he's working me and molding me, who he wants me to be.
I know that we all gonna be alright. We gon' make it through. It takes us all night, no matter what the odds may bring our way, I can see the blessings coming our way, yeah, yeah, yeah. Blessings on blessings, yeah, I can see the blessings coming our way, our way, our way. Blessings on blessings, yeah, I can see the blessings.
blessings coming my way.
I can see the blessings, I can feel your presence. Leaning on the change in my heart for your endeavors. I pray I'm your reflection, I fiend for your correction. The cross brought the connection in through Jesus' perfection. Life done hit me crazy, been more stressed than ever. Living like whatever, through the rain I feel you drawing closer. Lord, make me better, take me, shape me, use me, I am yours. Take me, break me, for the glory of the Lord. Okay, not only does he hold me when I'm down and feel I'm folding, he my coach when I'm the goalie, never lonely. Got that hope in he who holy, holy, holy. Keep that rugged cross all on me. Need that spirit to control me. Seek that word to come and mold me. Yeah, yeah. It's like I can feel the blessings coming my way. Yeah. It's like I can feel the blessings coming my way.
I know that we never gonna be alright. We gon' make it through if it takes us all night. No matter what the odds may bring, I'll wait. I can see the blessings coming our way. Yeah. Blessings on blessings, yeah. I can see the blessings coming our way. Our way, our way. Blessings on blessings, yeah. I can see the blessings coming our way.
Okay, my beloveds, we are moving into a little bit of gospel-inspired R&B, and that's it for the day. Okay, here we go with Mary J.
Give you peace of mind.
Was Frankie Beverly and Maze. That was the last song for today. And I wanted to end it with Happy Feelings. I hope that you enjoyed today's show as much as I did, creating it, putting it all together, because it was done with labor and love. So thank you again for your time, your attention, your energy, lending me your ears for yet another day. I appreciate you. You are super, super dope. You are worthy. You are valuable. You are stellar. And even if no one tells you that, look in the mirror and say that to yourself. I am a stellar, stunning human being. And I sway through the trials because I'm meant to bend, not to break. I appreciate you. Have a beautiful, beautiful, and blissfully, blissfully blessed day. Thank you. Take care of you. And thank you for all of my Visionary View listeners, okay? This is Red Sable. I am gone. For now, take care. Welcome back, beloved. I am Red Sable. And you've been listening to Fuel Your Soul. Thank you for your time and energy.
Make gonna leave me, baby, I plead. Sad about this love that is making me hazy.